Cavo is proud to deliver the IBM edition of the iMod for supporting the IBM Cloud. This video provides a quick start guide for deploying, testing, and managing applications or workloads on the IBM Cloud using the IBM edition of Cavo's iMod. Before you start using the IBM Cloud from iMod, you need to register at the IBM Cloud website to get a valid IBM Cloud account. After logging in for the first time, go to the Profile page. Click on Setup Accounts. Give a unique account name and enter username and password for the IBM Cloud. After creating an account, click on the arrow under the Key Pair column to go to the Key Pair Management page for the account. Create a new key pair. Make sure to leave Save Key in Server box checked. We store keys in AES 256 encrypted format in iMod. You can also upload your existing private key from the local drive. iMod communicates to the servers of SSH, and without the key pair, it wouldn't be able to connect to the servers. Now go to the End Tier page. You will see three options for deploying the application or workloads on the cloud. Deploy from Template allows you to use the best practice template for a given workload. Define New System allows you to define and configure a new complex multi-server workload using easy-to-use iMod UI wizard. Import System allows you to import and deploy the best practice template from your local drive. In this quick start tutorial, we will deploy a two-tier web application from the best practice template. This out-of-the-box template is provided as an example of deploying a two-tier application with the load balancer in the web tier and the Jira issue tracking app running on Tomcat in the app tier. Give a name to the system without spaces or special characters and click Deploy. After deploying the system, let's configure it using easy-to-use wizard. Let's pick Red Hat image for the load balancer. Let's pick SUSE image for the application tier. Some of the images require license keys. These images are not supported in this release. We will provide support for them in the next release. Before starting the system, let's configure events from the monitoring system with the corresponding complex workflows in the system definition file. In this example, we want to make sure that if one server in the application tier dies during testing, we can automatically fully recover the application by starting a new server and deploying software on it and configuring and starting the required services in the specified order. Now start the system with a single click. Within a few minutes, the entire infrastructure, middleware, and application will be up and running. You can manage the server by connecting to server over SSH. You can transfer files over SFTP between servers in the cloud and your local machine. We can simulate failure by killing one of the servers in the Jira tier from the IBM Cloud console. Within 90 seconds, iMod will detect the failure and execute the corresponding workflow to recover the application. In addition to automatically triggering workflows in response to events from the monitoring system, you can also trigger events manually by clicking the Event button and selecting the corresponding event. You can also use Scheduler to start or stop any system or to execute any complex workflow at scheduled times. All standard iMod features like monitoring, autopilot, alerts, scheduling, auto recovery, scale up, scale down, SSH connectivity, ability to transfer files over SFTP from local servers to servers in the cloud, accounting with the breakdown of server hours used by each workload are available to IBM Cloud users. For more information, please visit www.cavo.com.